Hey guys, welcome back to another deck idea, and this is going to be over my Salvo Dad deck. Now, I understand Salvo Dad isn't an original idea, it's existed. However, if you don't know what Salvo Dad is, just a quick history lesson. Excuse me, according to Yu-Gi-Oh! Wikia, which a lot of players, I know it could be edited, though this is the only source of information I actually found on Salvo Dad. This was a while ago, a long time ago, so I'm pretty sure I could find more viable information, but this is the one this is what I found so far, but Salvodad was actually created to succeed Teladad after Teladad got murdered by the ban list. However, it didn't have the speed and power of Teladad. And from my understanding, it's because it never had this much good support, because it actually received a lot of good support. Secondly, it only went into level 7s consistently. It couldn't bring the power of level 8 monsters, and that's where it failed in comparison. So I understand that's why it probably is not as popular as it is. It's not popular, and to be honest, I haven't seen any Salvo Dad decks. So if you are a Salvo Dad player, please help me out. I really would like to get into this deck, and I'd really like to help you guys help out Salvo Dad and see what we can do with it. Since it does have a lot of potential. So before I babble on, I'm going to go over the deck list and explain my choices along with it. So Black Salvo right here, if you don't know what it does, it just revives a dark level 4 machine type monster in face-up defense position. Of course, its effect is negated, and it's also your tuner. So this guy got you into your level 7s. I run 3. I don't know if 2 is a better number. So far, I had success with 3. Next, I run 3 Dacoichis. This is something Salvo Dead players ran back then because it was just a good floater, and it's still a good card just because being able to draw through your deck, of course, is a great thing, and floaters are always good. Next, I run 1 Cyber Dragon, which I think is odd to be honest, but this is my only way to get into level 8, which, as I said in the begin as I said in the history lesson or short history, level 7s failed in comparison to level 8, so Cyber Dragon was there. And also I also should put in the Chimera tech, but I haven't really experimented with side deck options yet. Next, I run 3 Gen X Neutron. So this is the very good support, one of the very good supports right here, because this guy would just go ahead and search out your Black Salvo. Also being light, that means BLS, of course, as you can see right here. And the great thing about this, other than being a Stratos, it only gets its effect during normal summon, but if you Veiler it still gets its effect because it just needs to be normal summon. That's all it needs. So the only way to really stop it is by solemn warning it. So that's another good thing. The Stratos of the deck is at 3. Next, I ran 3 Spy Descendant. No. No, I did not just time out. Oh, you know what? I'm not going to. And you know what? We'll just keep this in. It'll be a fun blooper right there. It'll be a fun blooper. You guys can enjoy that. Just laugh. Laugh your ass off. Okay, come on. No, it's all no, you guys are not supposed to see that. You guys aren't supposed to see that. Oh, thank you. It changed for me. Okay. Let's see. Yeah, I'm definitely keeping this in. I don't care. You guys, this is gonna be a good laugh for you guys. But anyway, back to what I was saying with Gravekeeper Spy and Descendant. So Gravekeeper Spy Descendant just allowed me to go into my level 4s. Of course, that's what Gravekeepers are good for. At least Spy. I know it's a bit slow, though. What I do like about it is that Descendant can go ahead and pop Thunder King, which really hurts the deck, since the deck is pretty much focused around searching. It doesn't really have any immediate options to go into any beaters. It doesn't really have any options to go into beaters, so it really can't protect its it really can't fight back unless it synchros into something. And also, it allows me to go into Arcanine Magician, which I really like in the deck, so I could, do different plays with it. So Rescue Rabbit right here. This is something I wanted to add in. So if you are current Salvo Dad player, if this doesn't work, and if there's a more consistent option, please let me know. But what I did was I did two rescue rabbits and only three mechanical chasers. I felt that this is going to be the most consistent part. I grabbed this book out of I grabbed this strategy out of Robo Rabbit, I believe that's what's the name, or Mechanical Rabbit. I don't know, but great thing about this is that becomes Rescue Rabbit becomes another Strauss, because that's gonna get you into your Gear Gigant X. So you could do something, summon Gear Gigant, search for Black Salvo, and you're really going to set up for Black Salvo play. Or you could just do something like summon a Neutron and search a Neutron, so you can just have that continuous flow of searching and deck thinning. And also, that's why I also run Digusta Emerald in here. I'm just going to point that out, just so I can recycle these guys back into my deck. Next, Tour Guides, because you never can run Tour Guides without Rescue Rabbit, because Levier is a card. Sangin, of course, it searches out your combo pieces. So pretty much everything in the deck is searchable, almost everything. Then BLS, I really hate using this card, but there's really no graveyard control in the deck other than summoning a Black Salvo and reviving something. So BLS just helps the dart count for Dark-Armed Dragon. And then Gores, 2 MST, Dark Hole, Ivy Storm, Monster Born, Mind Control, 2 Pots, and Allure. So the deck has a ton of consistency, I can promise you that. I played a couple games with it, and it's just really fast and explosive, though being a noob at it, I probably could have done some better plays. But so far, I really like it. Anyway, for the traps, the double summons, because this is why I like running for this format, which is the format of September 2012. Then 2 Boundless, 1 Torrential, 1 Mirrored Force. Some changes that I could see running maybe a Compulse or Stylite Rodan in the deck. That could probably help out, since a Torrential can really kill the setup of the deck. And next, for the extra deck, 1 Ancient Fairy, Black Rose, Arcanite, and 2 Scraps. I figured 2 Scraps would be very good for a deck, since it's a beater that you can go into immediately with Black Salvo, since outside of Scrap, you're probably gonna blow up the field with Black Rose. And Ancient Fairy is only good against decks that use field spells, which is primarily Dark Worlds, though Dark Worlds still rape the deck. And yeah, for level 8s, I only chose Stardust and Scrap if I ever have the chance to go into it, which there's only one way, and that is through Cyber Dragon. So that's another reason why I put Cyber Dragon in the deck, for that option. Now I run 2 Gear Gigant X. This guy is another Strauss, so you're running 5 Strauss in the deck. And you have 4 out of 30, 4 out of 35 chance of drawing it, since this is a 40 card deck. So your chances of drawing it is much better than drawing something like a single Strauss or a Rota. Now Utopia, Popio, Mindstroke, Emerald, Levier, and Wind Up Zenmain. So this is my Salvo Dad deck. I really like it. It works pretty well. It's very fast, but well, I couldn't say fast, but it's consistent. If it wasn't consistent, I don't think it's a really fast deck at all. But yeah, it's a very consistent deck, since there's just so much searching. The floaters are good. I mean, there's floaters everywhere. So yeah, this is how I approach the deck. One thing I will acknowledge is that Maxi will kill this deck, so that's where I fail in building the deck. So if you are a Salvadad player, if you have experience in Salvadad, please let me know. I really would like to start innovating this deck. So yeah, thank you for watching. I'm sorry for that screw up, and I'm keeping that in because I thought that was funny. Because my reaction, I really didn't know I was going to time out there. So yeah, thanks for watching. I look forward to more deck ideas.